episode, we'll talk about SR's contribution towards environmental conservation. I am Aditya Maharana, and I'll take you through all the initiatives taken by SR Oil Limited Vadinar to protect and to conserve the environment around which we function.
Green plants play a key role in maintaining ecological balance. Apart from their unique ability of harvesting solar energy through photosynthesis, they also play a vital role in shaping our environment. SR has undertaken tree plantation on a large scale in well-organized manner for the refinery and the power plant. The surrounding areas of refinery and power plant have been converted into greenbelt.
I have with us Dr. Jayaraman Gopal, who has the Health, Safety and Environment Department for the Energy Business here in SR Vadinar. Welcome, sir. Sir, tell us brief about the steps we take here for the curbing of air pollution here in the refinery.
The refinery is a complex process. It involves a lot of complex process. We have to take care at the design stage itself that the air emission, liquid emission, solid, hazardous solid discharge from the refinery, they are all brought under control and they should meet the national and state specifications. We comply with that 100%. There is no problem. We wanted to go much beyond the compliance level because nature is so dear to us. We are part of the nature and this refinery is a green refinery. You will find that this refinery, the next 2-3 years time, it will become totally green and we will see that people will be feeling rather happy to work in this green atmosphere.
So please tell us something about the green belt here in the refinery.
See, the green belt is the requirement to be complied as per the environment clearance. 1/3 of the area of this refinery is covered with green belt, which is approximately about 1,000 acres. Green belt is in the front side with the national highway side. We have covered green belt to a distance of 500 meters. On the other three periphery, it is about 50 to 100 meters. Green belt is you should plant 2,000 trees in 1 hectare. That means for every 10,000 square meter, you should have 2,000 trees and each tree will occupy about 5 square meter area. And the tree should be at least 10 meters height and it should take care of the complete greenery. That is called the green belt.
The refinery not only adheres to all the norms prescribed by the Pollution Control Board, but also has various processes in place to monitor any chances of air pollution.
The refinery has taken many green initiatives in environmental improvement in the refinery. And a very important tool is the environmental monitoring aspects inside the refinery. If you take an example of ambient air quality monitoring, stack monitoring, some of the VOC monitoring, noise monitoring, groundwater monitoring, in which there are fixed schedules are there inside the refinery on which the parameters are monitored inside the refinery, like ambient air quality. We have 7 ambient air quality monitoring stations are there in the refinery. We monitor twice in a week. Then we have stack monitoring. This is once in a month. The sulfur dioxide emissions, SPM, suspended particulate matter, it is also monitored inside the refinery. There are certain locations where we have to monitor the noise and which if there are some noise which are going beyond the limits, we have to control those locations. Coming to the groundwater aspects, very important. We have some identified borewells where we monitor if there are any suspected pollution, anything inside the refinery. There are external agencies we have engaged like National Institute of Oceanography for our marine environmental monitoring and as well as statutory requirements like environmental auditing, which has to be carried out inside the refinery, we have engaged National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, Nagpur.
The refinery also has its own nursery, which houses over 80,000 saplings. All the plants for the landscaping within the refinery and for the township are supplied from the nursery.
We
We have 5,000 square meter entire area of nursery, having more than 82,000 plant species. And we have different 16 categories or type of plants, having more than 96 different varieties. We have different indoor plants, outdoor plants. We have, particularly in indoors, we have more than 3,000 potted plants. And in outdoor particularly, we have flowering trees, flowering shrubs, flowering ground covers, green foliage plants, and seasonals.
SR Oil Limited has established SPM, jetty, approach road, and bund to facilitate the refinery. However, some of the jetty area falls under the Marine National Park. To protect and conserve the corals in the Marine National Park, SR has engaged with the National Institute of Oceanography, NIO, to carry out the translocation of subtidal as well as intertidal corals. NIO has carried out the translocation of these corals in association with the Marine National Park in April 2004.
In 2004, government has asked through Marine National Park to SR to translocate the corals along the route from jetty and from SPM to landfall pipeline, which is falling under Marine National Park. So SR has taken service of National Institute of Oceanography, Mumbai. And from National Institute of Oceanography, scientists has come over here and they have translocated the corals which are coming on the route, and they have taken it to the adjacent site and then continuously monitoring the same corals over the years. From 2004 onwards, we are continuously monitoring these corals for a survival and health of the status. Along with this monitoring of corals, we are also monitoring the water quality of this area, since we are operating petroleum products here, and how is the biological characteristics, that also we are monitoring it. So every year, once in a year, we are doing a comprehensive monitoring of entire marine environment. Then SR has taken one more step ahead, and though we are doing a monthly yearly monitoring by NIO, we have hired services of Gujarat Institute of Desert Ecology, which is a very prominent institute in Gujarat as far as the marine environment is concerned. So from 2009 onwards, we are again doing monthly monitoring for a few important locations like jetty, then pipeline corridor, then our SBM, our diffuser. So for that particular all four locations, we are monitoring water quality on monthly basis. This entire monitoring of National Institute of Oceanography as well as the Gujarat Institute of Desert Ecology, which has clearly demonstrated that in spite of our continuous operation of jetty as well as SPM, the marine environment as far as the water quality, sediment quality and biology and corals are concerned, it remains same as it was in the baseline in 1994.
The mangrove habitats of the Gulf of Kutch have been degraded due to various external pressures. SR has initiated voluntary plantation of mangrove in 150 hectare of the land identified by the Forest Department.
We are part of the team which is doing the plantation of the mangroves. Hectares and hectares of team, the mangroves have been planted in our area. The corals inspection, the discharge of water, which is being again sampled by expert team of experts. We take care of the that something is not going which is some contaminated water is not going being discharged into the sea, and the regular inspection of underwater areas of alongside our jetty with our own divers. They keep on inspecting the area that something has not gone, which is damaging the precious corals and other marine life of the sea.
Thank you.
That's all we have from Wadinar. On the other side of the break, more on SR's other environmental initiatives.